Wondering where SARS-CoV-2 comes from is more than just scientific interest, but rather the opposite. Understanding in detail its origins and how the virus ended up developing the current pandemic will actually allow us to react better in the future and ensure that such events will never occur again. A few weeks ago, the scientific journal Nature Medicine, one of the most prestigious in the world, published a paper that discusses precisely this issue. You can see the link in the description. In this video, we'll explain what is said in that work and what implication it has on scientific interest and public opinion. But let's clarify something first. All the hypotheses we are going to talk about cannot, in the state of current knowledge, be confirmed or denied. However, as we are going to see, there is evidence suggesting that some hypotheses are more likely than others. While the theories on the origin of SARS-CoV-2 are different, but can be synthesized in four main hypotheses. Number 1, natural selection in an animal before transfer to man. Number 2, natural selection in man before transferring from animal to man. Number 3, natural selection during the transition from animal to man. Number 4, voluntary or involuntary development in scientific research laboratories. But let's examine these hypotheses one by one and try to understand which are the most likely and why. According to the first hypothesis, SARS-CoV-2 naturally selected itself from some of its precursors inside one or more animals and then reached man. Evidence in favor of this hypothesis is given by a 96% overlap between the genome of the bat coronavirus RATG13 and SARS-CoV-2. It is therefore highly likely that the virus comes from the bat, which is its ultimate host. However, the two viruses and the RBT do differ, and their difference lies in that part of the virus surface as protein spike that binds the ACE2 enzyme. This enzyme acts as a receptor for the virus and allows it to enter the organism. This suggests that the virus must have passed through an intermediate host before it reached humans to acquire the ability to bind the human receptor. In this regard, pangolin coronaviruses, animals illegally imported to the Wuhan region, have an RBD very similar to that of SARS-CoV-2. Another aspect must be considered. Coronaviruses base their replication on an RNA polymerase with a very poor proofreading activity, that is to say, the correction of errors that may arise in the formation of the new filament. This means that coronaviruses can easily undergo mutations that can select new clones with different characteristics from their ancestors. In addition, it has been observed that when two coronaviruses infect the same host, RNA polymerase can produce proteins using the mRNA of either virus as a mold, making the encounter in the cytoplasm of the various proteins more likely. Try to picture this scenario. The bad virus with a genetic code superimposable on SARS-CoV-2 or the pangolin virus circulate in the respective animal population and acquire mutations that can select a new virus, which causes spillover events and infects human beings. Well, this new virus is SARS-CoV-2. At this point, from the infected animal, the virus finds a way to come into contact with a human being in a way that is still unclear, maybe through direct blood contact. Regardless of how reliable this hypothesis is, this first evidence has an important implication, which we're going to see later. The presence of these viruses in animals makes the creation of the virus in the laboratory more unlikely. But there's still a question. As explained in the video on etiopathogenesis, SARS-CoV-2 has regions on protein S where there are several basic amino acids, polybasic cleavage site, that can be attacked by proteases, thus causing the opening of the virus after binding the cell to infect. The polybasic cleavage site is absent in other viruses, including those just described on the pangolin and bat. So, can SARS-CoV-2 have them then? Is there something we're missing? Well, a first explanation can be found in biology. The polybasic cleavage site could be the result of random mutations, since they are located in the transition zone between the two subunits of the S protein, more subject to mutations, insertions, or deletions. In addition, we do not know all the coronaviruses of bats or pangolins, and there may be viruses that have polybasic cleavage sites but haven't been discovered yet. In any case, to acquire the mutations in the protein S for binding the human receptor and the polybasic cleavage site at the same time, well, SARS-CoV-2 must have already circulated in a high-density animal population to make natural selection happen more quickly. The host cell must have in its genome a gene for the ACE2 enzyme, similar to that of a human being. Hypothesis number 2, symmetrical to the previous one. A precursor could have passed from animals to humans, naturally selecting SARS-CoV-2 while passing from human to human. Well, this means that between the end of November 2019 and the beginning of December 2019, a progenitor of the current virus circulated among some humans, and that during the passages, the virus acquired the polybasic cleavage site that led to the beginning of its spread on a pandemic scale. This progenitor may have come from the pangolin, since, as we've seen, it is able to bind the human receptor. Well, this hypothesis appears more likely if we imagine that it was not just one progenitor, the rich man, but that more progenitors passed to man from different animals over a longer period. And this is what happens with a MERS-CoV, a close relative of SARS-CoV-2, which periodically passes to humans from dromedaries, causing single infections or small outbreaks. However, in order to prove this hypothesis, careful serological studies on humans to better understand the exposure before the pandemic are needed. Let's move to the third hypothesis. Apparently, SARS-CoV-2 developed during the transition from animal to human. In this regard, let's clarify something first. It is legitimate to wonder whether SARS-CoV-2 may have emerged during the handling of coronavirus in the laboratory, given that for years in various laboratories around the world, studies have been carried out using SARS-CoV, and that there have been episodes of virus escape in the past. While the virus may have taken on its RBD in the transition between different cell cultures, but when there are two hypotheses, we tend to give credit to the simpler one, and we have already discussed the high similarity between pangolin coronavirus RBD and SARS-CoV-2. Moreover, there are two other elements against the hypothesis of laboratory manipulation. Number one is that to create SARS-CoV-2, one of its progenitors should have been used, and until now, such a virus has never been reported in scientific literature. Number two, the acquisition of the polybasic cleavage site would have required repeated passages in cell and or animal cultures, and such a work has never been published in any scientific journal. Well, fourth and last hypothesis, the development in the laboratory. In addition to the considerations already made, the authors of the study this video is based on have tried to insert the RBD amino acid sequence of SARS-CoV-2 in a computer and to see from an informatics point of view if this structure was the best to interact with the human ACE2 receptor. Well, the software delivered combinations that were actually more optimal than those of the actual virus. And this is a proof that if someone had voluntarily wanted to design the virus in the laboratory, they wouldn't have used the sequence that the virus actually has. This means that RBD is likely the result of natural selection, rather than a deliberate creation in the laboratory. After all, we do not know the precise origin of the virus, but the knowledge we have gathered so far makes us believe that the virus has been naturally selected among the animal and/or human population. These theories will have to be confirmed or disproved in order to make useful decisions for the prevention of such future events.